Greetings, guys. Back at the movies, and as you can see from behind me, we have been invited to the Sydney premiere of the brand new film directed by Steven Soderbergh, and that is Magic Mike, The Last Dance. Now, it is the third installment in the Magic Mike franchise, and it stars the returning Channing Tatum and the new introduction of Salma Hayek. We're just about to head in and check this film out. Hopefully you enjoy the footage in the meantime, and I'll be back after this to let you know my thoughts on the film and have a bit of a chat about the production and give you a review. Talk to you soon.
So it'd be really cool if you could share it, hashtag Magic Mike's Last Dance, and also tag at Warner Brothers, Warner Bros. Rather, AU. Awesome. All right, guys, enjoy.
On the live show, that is a very arresting dance that really takes your breath away. It made us want to make a third movie. This is a place where we can redesign what Magic Mike actually is.
You cannot say that what we've created so far isn't special. And I'm not gonna just let us give up on it. This last day.
Hell yeah.
What did you want before Miami?
I just wanted to escape my life. I need you. Do you like bartending?
It's not really what I do.
What is it that you really do? But then you came along and gave me this unexpected, magical moment that made me remember who I really was. Come with me to London.
Are you in London?
I'm gonna put on a show at this famous theater.
People are numb, disconnected. We're gonna wake them up with a wave of passion they've never felt before.
Hell yeah.
Without further ado, I give you the visionary artist, Magic Mike.
So,
the real question is, why do you love her?
No one's believed in me like your mom has. What's this show about?
It's the same old, will she marry for love or money?
So what does she pick, love or money?
The real question is, why does she feel like she has to choose?
It sounds to me she just needs to let go.
And some good.
Maybe that as well.
You're not shutting me down, not this time.
You're so good at this. I'm not gonna just let us give up on it.
I want every woman that walks into this theater to feel that a woman can have whatever she wants, whenever she wants. This last day.
Wait, I know you. You were a cop, right?
Did you arrest her?
What's your name?
Kim.
Let you out for the warning, right?
Greetings once again, guys. Just got out of seeing the latest Magic Mike movie, and that is the third installment, believe it or not, and that is Magic Mike, The Last Dance. I mean, interestingly, it is directed by Steven Soderbergh, who actually returns. He directed the first Magic Mike movie all the way back in 2012, so it has been quite a bit of time. My first thoughts, it's interesting, definitely. You really do know if you're going to see this movie. It is full of entertainment, particularly for lovers of kind of male entertainers, I guess, and also lovers of kind of Channing Tatum. Salma Hayek really adds a bit of gravitas to this film as well, so she's a really good addition. I do have to say, though, compared to some of the star-studded cast in the previous installments, it does feel a little bit low on that star power. And really, those first two films had a really good cast in spite of the narrative around those films just being essentially a little bit of light entertainment. The first one, just to give a bit of context, it actually was quite gritty. Steven Soderbergh really a great reputation. He directed films such as Out of Sight, and also a notably good cinematographer as well. That first film, really, it's quite gritty, and it really does kind of show that the darker side of that kind of industry. And it's really an interesting character piece, considering you have the contrast between Matthew McConaughey's character and also Channing Tatum as Mike, and how they kind of go on these different kind of paths. One kind of stays on it, and the other one kind of is really wanting to, you know, come back to reality, essentially. And of course, the second installment, probably a bit weaker than the first, which was essentially a road trip kind of movie, a bunch of light entertainment, and it was humorous, but there was really not too much plot to it. This film, kind of a bit similar in a way. It starts off, well, the first act's kind of quite entertaining and charming in some ways. A lot of that's to do with Channing Tatum and Salma Hayek. But I have to say, the middle, a little bit slow on the narrative drive, and that's kind of when they go to London, which is a little bit of an odd choice, I think, narratively. And it actually surprised me that Steven Soderbergh was actually involved with this, because it didn't feel like his typical gritty style, even though his cinematography, it does feel a little bit of a similar kind of palette and tone compared to some of his previous work. But that middle, a little bit hard to kind of negotiate, and I really think audiences are going to say to themselves, hey, where's what we've come for? That really comes in the third act, so they really do make audiences wait for this. And in some ways it feels a bit like an advertisement for the Magic Mike show that kind of Channing Tatum put together. But really that last act is entertaining, and it has a lot of really great artistry through dance. I thought it was really admirable. There's a particular person in this film that I have to really give credit to. She is a fabulous dancer, and she has a fantastic sequence with Channing Tatum, and her name is Kylie Shea. She is a ballerina and she is phenomenal just in that sequence. It's very limited, but I think that's just worth the price of admission. That sequence is quite amazing. It involves water and rain, and it's kind of towards the conclusion of the film. I thought it was really smart, but in saying that, I do have to say the plot is quite thin, and really, I think you really do know if you're going to see this film before anyone gives you a review for it. It does have those kind of aspects, but you do have to wait a little bit for them. There is quite a bit. That whole third act is essentially pretty much a show, which is quite interesting. So really, I think audiences will be happy because of that. But I do have to say, it is the weakest of the three, and that first one is really strong. And on some level, it did get some critical praise just from some of the elements that it explored. This film, a little bit weak, but in saying that, the first act, pretty solid, and the cast, particularly Channing Tatum and, of course, Salma Hayek, they really do a good job. There is a few additional cameos in this, but not enough to kind of bring those characters back. They are humorous when you do see them, but really it is Channing Tatum's kind of film, but really I don't think they utilize him enough in this, and you'll know when you see it, I'll just say that. But really the weakest of the three, unfortunately. There's some entertainment value in this, it's light entertainment, but the plot is thin, I'll just warn you regarding that. And probably is worthwhile exploring some of those previous films as well if you can, because it will give you a bit of a lead up in some context about what happens in this film. Also, I do have to say there's a bit of a few weird creative choices, such as a voiceover in this. When you see it, you'll know what I'm talking about. Some odd creative choices, not as strong as the first film, and compared to the second film, I think the second film's a little bit more fun in some ways. This one kind of takes some interesting choices, but the final act and the first act, pretty decent. The middle's a little bit weak, let's just say that. But aside from that, I'm about to head off. Hopefully you enjoy the footage from tonight, and I'll catch you guys at the next one.